The 2021 S's Tough A15 builds and updates on the previous generation, with a slightly redesigned exterior, updated hardware and wireless configurations, a much nicer screen option, and a 90 watts battery on all variants. Hi! Welcome to Tech Quadrangle, but before we proceed, I would like to say a quick shout to Mr. Mystery the White Dragon, Chef Don215 and Chemo Ketch. Thank you for your support. I do a random shout out from my subscribers. If you want to get mentioned in my next video, subscribe now. And remember to check the description below for pricing and the latest deals on the products mentioned. Without further ado, let's do justice to this great budget gaming laptop. Early this year, Asus has updated the Tough A15 series with 2021 AMD Ryzen 5000H processors and NVIDIA RTX 3000 graphics, a better screen option of 240Hz panel with 3ms response and 100% sRGB colors. The internal thermal design is updated for improved air intakes on the bottom. Our reviewed laptop is specced with 15 inches full HD 1080p IPS display, 144Hz refresh rate with 3ms, covers 100% sRGB and has adaptive sync technology. Runs on new AMD's Ryzen 7 5800H, 8-core, 16-threads processor. The RAM is 16GB, expandable to 32GB, with NVIDIA RTX 3070 GPU, while the storage is 1TB NVMe SSD. Starting with the design, not much has changed with the 2021 Tough A15 in terms of the overall design and build lines, with two exceptions: the lid looks a little different and the bottom has been remade to allow better air intake into the fans. The laptop is still made out of plastics, with a textured black interior and rougher materials used for the underside and bezels. The interior feels okay for the class and comfortable with daily use. The underside is also made out of plastics too and houses cuts for the speakers and air intakes. As for practicality, this Tough sits sturdily on a flat surface thanks to the grippy rubber feet on the bottom, and the screen can be easily picked up with a single hand. Weighing 2.3 kilograms or 5.07 pounds, the laptop is fair-sized, but not as lightweight or as compact as some of the other options available out there. The I/O is crammed on the left side, leaving the right for large air exhaust and one extra USB port. There is no SD card reader, no biometrics, and the USB-C doesn't support charging. The bezels are quite thin with a 720p webcam on top. As for the keyboard, it hasn't changed at all from the previous Tough A15. The layout includes a set of full-sized and properly spaced main keys and a numpad section at the right, with narrower keys. The keys are single-zone RGB backlit and the plastic keycaps feel nice to the touch. The plastic touchpad is a bit small with dedicated click buttons but works very well. As for the display, it comes 144Hz panel with 300 nits peak brightness, 98.7% sRGB and faster response time. The panel also supports FreeSync, a technology that takes care of tearing in games. Overall, this is a versatile screen for a mid-tier laptop, fine for daily use and an excellent option for gaming. However, it might not be sufficient for content creators looking for top color accuracy. When it comes to performance, the 2021 Asus Tough A15 is built on the latest AMD and NVIDIA hardware Ryzen 7 5800H processor and NVIDIA RTX 3070 graphics card. This enormous power can be unleashed according to gamers' needs, via the Asus Armoury Crate power profiles. Gamer can choose between silent, performance and turbo power profiles. With silent producing the least amount of power and fan noise, whilst the turbo gives the highest power output with most fan noise. Turbo is only available with the laptop plugged in and is meant for gaming and other demanding loads. Performance is a jack of all trades, while silent is made for video and daily light use. As for the RAM and storage options, the laptop still comes with two accessible memory DIMMs and M.2 SSD slots. Our unit shipped with 16GB of RAM in dual channel and a very fast 1TB SSD. I need to mention that during testing, the SSD can run hot if you're transferring a huge amount of data, causing a bit of thermal throttling. However, on daily use, this was not noticed. Overall, the Ryzen 7 5800H ends up outmatching the Ryzen 7 4800H in the 2020 model by as much as 20% in Blender. I won't be going into details of the performance results of this laptop across different performance software, as there are many videos on YouTube on that. However, here are how some DX11, DX12 and Vulcan titles performed on the stock turbo, performance and silent profiles. The thermal design of the new ESA's TUF A15 2021 is overhauled with 10% higher capacity fans. The secondary GPU heatpipe at the left is now linked to the CPU as well. However, the CPU is still applied with regular thermal compound and not liquid metal as on the ROG models. If you would like to see our review of the best 2021 ESA's ROG, click on the link above. In all fairness, the 2021 A15 seems to run 1 to 2 decibels quieter on the turbo mode than the previous model did, and a fair bit quieter on performance. The silent profile is a welcomed update with daily use, as it allows the fans to switch off as long as the hardware doesn't go above 60 degrees Celsius or 140 degrees Fahrenheit. Silent might also make sense for lighter gaming sessions, but performance is throttled under this setting. The silent profile setting doesn't seem to work properly in some recent games. The pros are fair design, build quality and inputs. Improved IPS 240Hz display. Excellent performance across the board, a significant bump over the 2020 A15. Long battery life. And the cons are still no card reader or biometrics. Poor audio quality. SSD runs hot on very large transfers. My final thoughts on this laptop are that the 2021 TUF A15 is faster across the board in daily use, demanding workloads, and games. It also runs more efficiently on battery and quieter with daily use, with the fans now able to shut off completely and allow for a silent experience. On top of these, ESA's finally put a good screen on the TUF series, the 240Hz fast panel with 100% sRGB colors, previously only an option on the ROG models. However, the downside is that this latest model doesn't seem to fix the complaint of the 2020 ESA's TUF A15, which is the high CPU, GPU temperatures in longer gaming sessions. But lifting the A15 from the desk to improve the air intake into the fans and underneath the laptop helps lower these temperatures by 2 to 5 degrees, and also using a capable cooling pad would help even further. My recommended cooling pad is in the description below. And that pretty much wraps up our review. What do you think of the ESA's TUF A15 2021? Is it going to be your next gaming laptop? Do let me know in the comments below. And if you enjoyed this video, please go ahead and leave a like, so that YouTube can suggest it to a wider audience. If you're new to the channel and would like to see more content like this, hit that subscribe button and turn on all notifications so you won't miss our next upload. Be sure to check out the description for links to find the most up-to-date pricing and deals on the products mentioned in this video. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.